Winnie the Pooh by A.A. Milne. Chapter 2, in which Pooh goes visiting and gets into a tight place. Winnie the Pooh was humming to himself and walking along gaily, wondering what everyone else was doing and what it felt like being somebody else, when suddenly he came to a sandy bank, and in the bank was a large hole. "Aha," said Pooh, "if I know anything about anything, that hole means rabbit," he said, "and rabbit means company," he said, "and company means food and listening to me humming and such." So he bent down, put his head into the hole, and called out, "Is anybody home?" There was a sudden scuffling noise from inside the hole, and then silence. "What I said was, is anybody home?" called out Pooh very loudly. "No," said a voice, and then added, "You needn't shout so loud. I heard you quite well the first time." "Bother," said Pooh. "Isn't there anybody there at all?" "Nobody." Winnie the Pooh took his head out of the hole and thought for a little, and he thought to himself, "There must be somebody there, because somebody must have said nobody." So he put his head back in the hole and said, "Hello, Rabbit, isn't that you?" "No," said Rabbit in a different sort of voice this time. "But isn't that Rabbit's voice?" "I don't think so," said Rabbit. "It isn't meant to be." "Oh," said Pooh. He took his head out of the hole and had another think, and then he put it back and said, "Well, could you very kindly tell me where Rabbit is?" "He has gone to see his friend Pooh Bear, who is a very great friend of his." "But this is me," said Bear, very much surprised. "What sort of me?" "Pooh Bear." "Are you sure?" said Rabbit, still more surprised. "Quite, quite sure," said Pooh. "Oh, well, then come in." So Pooh pushed and pushed and pushed his way through the hole, and at last he got in. "You are quite right," said Rabbit, looking at him all over. "It is you. Glad to see you." "Who did you think it was?" "Well, I wasn't quite sure. You know how it is in the forest. You can't have anybody come over one's house. One must be careful." "What about a mouthful of something?" Pooh always liked a little something at 11 o'clock in the morning, and he was very glad to see Rabbit getting out the plates and mugs. And when Rabbit said, "Honey or condensed milk with your bread?" he was so excited that he said, "Both." And then, not to seem greedy, he added, "But don't bother about the bread, please." And for a long time after, he said nothing, until at last, humming to himself in a rather sticky voice, he got up, shook Rabbit lovingly by the paw, and said that he must be going. "Must you?" said Rabbit politely. "Well," said Pooh, "I could stay longer if you," and he tried very hard to look in the direction of the larder. "As a matter of fact," said Rabbit, "I was going out myself directly." "Oh, well then, I'll be going on. Goodbye." "Well, goodbye, if you're sure you won't have any more." "Is there any more?" asked Pooh quickly. Rabbit took the covers off the dishes and said, "No, there wasn't." "I thought not," said Pooh, nodding to himself. "Well, goodbye, I must be going on." So he started to climb out of the hole. He pulled with his front paws, and he pushed with his back paws, and a little while his nose was out in the open again, and then his ears, and then his front paws, and then his shoulders, and then... "Oh, help," said Pooh, "I'd better go back." "Oh, bother," said Pooh, "I shall have to go on." "I can't do either," said Pooh, "oh, help and bother." Now by this time, Rabbit wanted to go out for a walk too, and finding the front door full, he went out the back door, and he came round to Pooh and looked at him. "Hello, are you stuck?" he asked. "No," said Pooh carelessly, "just resting and thinking and humming to myself." "Here, Give us a paw. Pooh Bear stretched out a paw, and Rabbit pulled and pulled and pulled. Ow! Cried Pooh, you're hurting. The fact is, said Rabbit, you're stuck. It all comes, said Pooh crossly, of not having front doors big enough. It all comes, said Rabbit sternly, of eating too much. I thought at the time, only I didn't say anything, that one of us was eating too much, and I knew it wasn't me. Well, well, I shall go fetch Christopher Robin. Christopher Robin lived at the other end of the forest, and when he came back with Rabbit, and he saw the front half of Pooh, he said, Silly old bear, in such a loving voice that everybody felt quite hopeful again. I was just beginning to think, said Bear, sniffing slightly, that Rabbit might never be able to use his front door again, and I should hate that, he said. So should I, said Rabbit. Use his front door again, said Christopher Robin. Of course he'll use his front door again. Good, said Rabbit. If we can't pull you out, Pooh, we might push you back. Rabbit scratched his whiskers thoughtfully and pointed out that when once Pooh was pushed back, he was back, and of course nobody was more glad to see Pooh than he was. Still, there it was. Some lived in trees, and some lived underground, and... You mean I'd never get out? Said Pooh. I mean, said Rabbit, that having got so far, it seems a pity to waste it. Christopher Robin nodded. Then there's only one thing to be done, he said. We shall have to wait for you to get thin again. How long does getting thin take? Asked Pooh anxiously. About a week, I should think. But I can't stay here a week. You can stay here, all right, silly old bear. It's getting you out, which is so difficult. We'll read to you, said Rabbit cheerfully. And I hope it won't snow, he added. And I say, old fellow, you're taking up a good deal of room in my house. Do you mind if I use your back legs as a towel horse? Because, I mean, they are there, doing nothing, and it would be very convenient just to hang the towels on them. A week, said Pooh gloomily. What about meals? I'm afraid no meals, said Christopher Robin, because of getting thin quicker. But we will read to you. Bear began to sigh, and then found he couldn't, because he was so tightly stuck, and a tear rolled down his eyes, as he said, Then would you read a sustaining book, such as would help and comfort a wedged bear in great tightness? So for a week, Christopher Robin read that sort of book at the north end of Pooh, and Rabbit hung his washing on the south end, and in between, Bear felt himself getting slenderer and slenderer, and at the end of the week, Christopher Robin said, Now! So he took hold of Pooh's front paws, and Rabbit took hold of Christopher Robin, and all Rabbit's friends and relations took hold of Rabbit, and they all pulled together. And for a long time, Pooh only said, Ow! And oh! And then, all of a sudden, he said, Pop! Just as if a cork was coming out of a bottle. And Christopher Robin and Rabbit and all Rabbit's friends and relations went head over heels backwards. And on the top of them came Winnie the Pooh, free. So with a nod of thanks to his friends, he went on with his walk through the forest, humming proudly to himself. But Christopher Robin looked after him lovingly and said to himself, Silly old bear. Thank you. Take care.